What's going on, guys? I know it's been a few weeks. However, we are coming back with a new review for you today. And today, it's a TV show. It's a TV show that's an Amazon original. And it's written by a really good writer. For those of you who don't know, Greg Daniels is... he is really good at what he does in terms of being a TV show writer. You might have recognized his name if you are big avid fans of The Office, Parks and Recreation. He's also, I'm pretty sure, written a lot of King of the Hill. He's done some things with some other shows. He's also currently about to launch on Netflix an original called Space Force, which a lot of people are saying if you like The Office, it's pretty much the space version of The Office. It's even got Steve Carell in it, just like in The Office. So it's going to be a really exciting show. I'll definitely be talking more about that, but we're talking about Greg Daniels' other new show that's come out, and it is Upload. Upload is a really interesting concept because it delves into a lot of things of life after death, or essentially a virtual life. You know, you're no longer an IRL anymore when you die. And so that's one of the things we're going to discuss today. This show only had 10 episodes for the first season. It all launched at once off of Amazon, so you need Amazon Prime to access the content, which some people might find worth it, some people might not. It just depends. If you already have Amazon Prime, or, you know, your parents, however you get access to it, definitely get a chance to check this show out. This show is definitely funny. It's written really well. It hits a lot of the interesting points that it's trying to make, especially in terms of things about consumerism, which we'll be talking about more. So the show follows this guy. This guy meets an untimely demise, and so he is actually dying, and so he has the chance of either dying of natural causes, or he could be uploaded to a service, a cloud service, to which some big companies would own. And so if he were to do that, then he gets scanned, his whole head gets scanned, and then his conscience, as they say, is uploaded into this cloud or this virtual world hotel where he gets to live out the rest of his virtual afterlife. Of course, this show doesn't just tackle this in the basic sense. This show goes really deep in terms of what it means of life after death. There is a side character throughout the show where he firmly believes in what they consider the old ways, which is, you know, believing that there is something called like a heaven, which they don't really use the word heaven. They use sort of like this old school way of viewing the afterlife. Which, of course, some of us believe, and so we're not going to dive into what's right and wrong or what is true or not true in terms of life after death. It's just this show is just trying to bring up those issues in a more deeper sense while keeping it very lighthearted throughout the show's runtime. These episodes are on the fairly long side. A lot of Amazon original shows seem to be that way. The first few episodes are within that 40-minute range, and then they kind of start lowering to the 30 to 40-minute range, which I think is really nice. It makes binging the show really hard. Shows like The Office or like Parks and Rec, where they're within the normal TV show time slot, those episodes are shorter, which means it's easier to watch multiple episodes of in one sitting. Ones like these, you're like watching a mini movie at every episode. It's when I tried to watch the Tom Clancy show that John Krasinski is in. It's hard to binge because they're almost hour-long episodes. And when there's multiple episodes, you just want to keep going, keep going, keep going. But it just gets difficult. The premise of the show, of course, is really interesting. I really thought it was going to be a lot like The Office, where if you watch The Office Ladies or listen to The Office Ladies podcast, they talked about recording the shows out of order. They didn't know which episodes would go into which, especially in the early seasons of The Office. I thought the show was going to be a lot like that. I thought it was going to be a lot of just episodes where it's just him trying to live out his daily life, when in reality, this big overarching story is in every single episode. It has a lot of meaning to it, and it's really cool. It's definitely not like The Office in terms of just episodes. They're kind of just their little one-offs. Of course, there are a lot of different times in each episode where that doesn't really matter much to the story. But overall, I think the show is very hilarious and it's a lot of fun. In terms of the appropriate age for watching this show, it's definitely more geared towards adults. The language is definitely higher up there. The adult content is definitely on the higher end of that spectrum. I would definitely make sure, as a parent, that you watch the show first. The first two episodes definitely should give you a really good feel about how this show works, especially in terms of its humor, its language, in terms of its adult content. If you feel like your child, who I would recommend at least above the age of 15 or so, is definitely old enough to view this, definitely take a chance to watch it first. As an adult, as a parent, I think the show is funny. I think it's hilarious. But my kids, they're too young to understand anything anyway, but I would definitely wait till they're a little bit older to watch a show like this. It's definitely something to keep in mind. Overall, I think the show's really good. I'm excited for a second season. It did get approved for a second season. I don't know if they're going to get a chance to record because of the whole COVID-19 thing that's going on. That's also why I get a really cool opportunity to be doing this YouTube channel right now, because I have a lot of free time on my hands, a lot of free time to read, a lot of free time to watch and play some games. And so I'm excited to continue doing more of these videos as time goes on. So please put your questions about what you want me to see next, anything I might have missed, anything you would want to put your opinions about in a respectful way in the comments below. Please like the video. That way, you know, the YouTube algorithm thinks that people actually want to watch this. Please subscribe so that way you get a chance to be more involved, as well as hit the notification bell. That way, anytime a video goes up, I'm trying to upload these videos every Monday, and I have something else that might come out in the later parts of the week. So I'm working through that. So please bear with me as we're continuing to expand this channel to do more and to experience more, so that you guys can continue to see everything that we are going through with this channel. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Once again, continue consuming that content, continue being pioneers in understanding the world, whether that's through the lenses of reading, through the lenses of watching, through the lenses of playing, and through especially the lenses of voicing your opinion. That's one of the things I like to try and do with this channel. I've always had opinions and views on things, but I always felt like I needed a solid platform to do it, especially on things like media and on things like content like this. And so please don't forget to like and subscribe and to hit the notification bell. That way you can stay up to date and you can tell me that you want to keep seeing more. So please, thank you for watching. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys next time. Have a great day.